Let us receive the family for Bishop Broom. Lord, who shall abide in thy tabernacle? Who shall dwell in thy holy hill? He that walketh uprightly and worketh righteousness and speaketh the truth in his heart. He that backbiteth not with his tongue, nor doeth evil to his neighbor. Nor taketh up reproach against his neighbor. In whose eyes a vile person is condemned, but he honoreth them that fear the Lord. He that sweareth to his own hurt and changeth not. He that putteth not out his money to usury, nor taketh reward against the innocent. He that doeth these things shall never be moved. I'm going to ask that the members of the College of Bishops, you may be seated, with the exception of the College of Bishops for the Church of God in Christ, as the presiding bishop and general board prepare to remove two symbols of the office of the bishop from the remains of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom. My dear brothers and sisters, as we prepare to remove these symbols, the pectoral cross and ring, this cross of gold that hung around the bishop's neck was a symbol of his imprisonment for Christ. Bishop Lee Vicker Broom was inducted into the College of Bishops in the year of 1995. The cross was a constant reminder that he was a servant first to the Lord's church, and the Lord's people. The ring symbolized the priestly authority of the bishop by the church. It is now being presented to the widow of Bishop Broom, Mother Martha Broom. The National Adjutancy now prepares to seal the bier. We cover the body of the bishop with a purple cloth. Purple represents the office of the bishop. The cloth symbolizes the shroud placed upon the body of our Lord at his death, according to the 19th chapter of John's Gospel. We continue the celebration by covering the bishop's face with a napkin. John, the 20th chapter, verse 7, teaches us that there was a napkin or face cloth that was placed upon the head of Jesus. The final document placed in the bier with the bishop is the Annales Ministeri, Episcopatus et Mortis. This document and tribute is only given to members of the Episcopacy of the Church of God in Christ. The Annales reads as follows: The Chronicle of Ministry, Episcopacy, and Death. He arrests the Right Reverend Lee Vicker Broom, priest, prince, and prophet, born on Friday, March 26, 1937, husband of 50 years to Mother Martha Broom, father of four children, served the Oklahoma Northwest Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction in numerous areas of ministry. Consecrated to the episcopacy in 1995, promoted to glory on Friday, the 14th day of April, in the year of our Lord, 2023. This will be received by Deputy Adjutant General Glenn McKinney. One will be placed in the bier and the other given to Mother Broom. The pall that covers the bier or vessel, it represents the true servant leadership of this man of God. Bishop Broom believed that the people did not exist to serve him, but rather he existed to serve the people. The life of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom, it will always be celebrated as a courageous soldier in the army of our Lord. Bishop Broom fought a good fight. He finished his course. He kept the faith. And there is laid up for him now a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give him in that day. Let us put our hands together and celebrate the life, the service, the legacy of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom. The gentleman who served him in life now serves him in death. The seating of the Episcopal adjutant in the person of Elder Raymond Weathered. At the direction of the presiding bishop of the Church of God in Christ, the flag that hangs in front of Mason Temple bearing the seal of the church is lowered to half mast. We have come today to celebrate. We have come today to celebrate. We have come today to celebrate. Let us receive the secretary for the General Board in the person of the Bishop Brandon Burdett Porter, who will lead us further in this worship celebration.
Let's give God more praise. Can we do that? He's worthy. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. So as Bishop Wells said emphatically, we are here to worship and honor and thank God for the life of this tremendous soldier and great, great humanitarian. Come on, let's thank God for Bishop Broom. We're going right along because our time is challenged, of course, and please, presiding bishop and the general board always dresses in our ceremonial attire, but because the weather's been so challenged, flights being canceled, and us getting here so late, that we would not have had ample time to serve you and to put on our vestments. So please forgive us, but know that we respect and honor this man of God. Amen. Will you thank God for our presiding bishop and general board for being here? Amen. God bless you. At this time, the hymn of comfort by the C.H. Mason Memorial Choir, and following the hymn of comfort will be the general board member, Reverend Prince Bryant of Houston, Texas, the Old Testament scripture by general board member Elijah Hankerson III from St. Louis, Missouri, and then the chorus, of course, and then a New Testament by the Reverend Glenn McKinney. In that order, thank you.
Day when the mists are rolled away, we will understand it better by and by. By and by, when the morning comes, when all of the saints will be gathered, we'll tell it of how we've overcome. We will understand it better by and by. We are often destitute of the things that life demands. Want of food and want of shelter, thirsty hills and barren lands. We are trusting in the Lord, and according to His word, we will understand it better by and by. Oh, by and by, when the morning comes, when all of us saints will be gathered, we'll tell our story of how we've overcome, and we'll understand it. Temptation, hidden snares often take us unaware, and our hearts are made to bleed from any thoughtless word or deed. And we wonder why the test, when we try to do our best, but we'll understand it better by and by. Oh, by and by, when that morning comes, when all of the saints of God will be gathered, and we'll tell our story. Yes, we will. How? And we'll understand it. Yes, we will. By and by. Oh, by and by. Oh, when that morning comes, when all of the saints of God will be gathered home, we will tell the story of how we've overcome. Yes, we'll understand it. Yes, we will. By and by, by and by, when that morning comes, when all of the saints of God will be gathered home, and we'll tell the story how we've overcome. Oh, and we'll understand it better by and by.
Reverence hearts. Our Father and our God, today we thank you. We thank you for being our God and our Savior. You're the great shepherd of the sheep and the soon coming King. Thou who art over us, and thou who art with us, and thou who art one of us. Today, our Father, we acknowledge your sovereign reign over our lives. You rule and super rule. You reign supreme. You're the author of life and the giver of eternal life. You're omnipotent. All power's in your hand. You're omniscient, omnipresent. You're here right now. You're the Emmanuel, you're the God with us. You're holy and just. You're righteous. You're faithful and merciful. You alone are worthy of our praise. And we do praise you today. With the fruit of our lips, we give you praise. We bless your name. Hallelujah. We'll give you honor. Thank you, Jesus. Come on and tell him thank you. Come on and tell the Lord thank you for your goodness and your greatness, for your sovereign rule. You're the horn of our salvation. Your very present help in the time of trouble. We acknowledge our need of thee. Oh, how I need thee. We need you right now. Look on Mother Broom. Look on this entire family today. Look on our presiding bishop in the general board. Look on the Church of God in Christ. Jesus, Jesus, Mary's baby, the lily of the valley, the bright morning star. We need you now. Come on in and heal every hurt. Come on in and lift every bowed down head. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Your grace is amazing. Your strength is present. Your joy is with us. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. Fill us with your joy, and we'll have your strength today. Now bless this service. Bless our leader. Bless this family. Give us your grace and mercy. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let's say praise the Lord for the prayer. Give God the praise for the strength that we have received from that prayer. And as we go in the strength of that prayer, we'd like to call your attention at this time to the book of Isaiah, the 40th chapter, verses 28 through 31. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 28 says, "Hast thou not known, hast thou not heard, that the everlasting God, the Lord, the creator of the ends of the earth, fainteth not, neither is weary. There is no searching of his understanding. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increases strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord," hallelujah, "shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." This is the word of the Lord.
I'll be reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 51 and following. And it reads, "Behold, I show you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." May God add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word.
Praise the Lord. At this time, we will have the affirmation of faith by General Board Member Malcolm Colby of Oklahoma City. Praise God for him. And following him, the selection by this great choir, and we thank God for them. They're going to bless us with a selection following Bishop Colby.
Saints, as we stand now to accept the family, share the affirmation of our faith, let us with confidence and commitment and great reverence read it together. We affirm our faith in the Bible. We affirm the Bible to be the inspired and only infallible written word. We affirm our faith in God. We believe that there is one God, eternally existent in three persons, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. We affirm our faith in the blessed hope. We believe in the blessed hope, which is the rapture of the church of God, which is in Christ at his return. We affirm our faith in repentance and salvation. We believe that the only means of being cleansed from sin is through repentance and faith in the precious blood, Jesus Christ. We believe that regeneration by the Holy Ghost is absolutely essential for personal salvation. We affirm our faith in Jesus Christ. We believe that the redemptive work of Christ on the cross provides healing for the human body in answer to believing prayer. We affirm our faith in the Holy Ghost. We believe that the baptism in the Holy Ghost, according to Acts 2 and 4, is given to believers who ask for it. And we affirm our faith in sanctification. We believe in the sanctifying power of the Holy Spirit, by whose indwelling the Christian is enabled to live a holy and separated life in this present world. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Y'all ready for this great celebration? We're going to celebrate, amen. Put your hands together. We're going to celebrate. Yeah. until that curtain comes. Not until the general roll. Not until they're in this world. And the saints are gone. Then we'll crown him. Crown him. Together. Crown him. Then we'll crown King Jesus. Hey, but you gotta wait to wait. Wait till I get there.
Just told y'all we gotta get out of here. Hey, excuse me. Excuse me, excuse me. Excuse me, excuse me. Well, y'all act like y'all on y'all way for real. Somebody asked me the other day around Resurrection Sunday, Jesus told the thief, today you'll be with me in paradise. They said, well, Pastor, where is paradise? I said, I know exactly where it is. Look at somebody and say, he knows exactly where it is. Why don't you ask me, where is paradise? Wherever Jesus is, that's where paradise is. And we're going to have a good time. Amen, somebody. I'm going. Y'all, now Now listen, y'all got to stop, because we got, and nobody dances and praises God more than our presiding bishop. But he is timely. Amen. But why don't you take 30 seconds? Go on and praise him if you're going to praise him. Good time. Hallelujah. My God, my God. Hallelujah. Thank you. Now, which one of y'all in charge? I see David up there. Who's in charge so I know who to fuss at? All right. Y'all, this means stop, all right? Now, make some noise when I do it. Come on, say. You're supposed to hit it. That's what that means, stop. But Lord have mercy, when I did that, I felt something on the inside. Lord have mercy. Wait a minute. Stop it. Die! God, my God. You missed it. Listen. Where you get a tambourine from? I ain't seen those and I don't know when. At this time. Oh, nothing wrong with having church, though. Look at somebody and say, our bishop was saved. Is that right? Lady Sarah Jordan Powell, love you, sweetheart. When I was coming in, she said, this was my bishop, and I know that. I've known that for years. At this time, we've got tributes and in behalf of the International Women's Department, and our women's department is amazing in the Church of God in Christ. Under the leadership of Dr. Barbara McCoo Lewis, General Supervisor, and representing her today will be Mother Gladys Lockett Rose, Supervisor, Supervisor Department of Women for Texas Central Metropolitan Jurisdiction. And she's going to, hello love, she's going to come at this time. And let's thank God while she's coming for a supervisor for this jurisdiction. Amen. And that's Mother Corrine Hoffman, right? God bless you. Love you.
Let's praise the Lord for this beautiful, auspicious, homegoing celebration for a man of God. We certainly praise the Lord on today. I certainly honor the Lord who is head of my life and has given me strength to be here on today. I certainly honor our Bishop John Drew Sheard, Chief Apostle of the Church of God in Christ around the world. Let's give him a hand praise. Our general board, Bishop Colby, Bishop Porter, Bishop Bryant, Bishop Hankerson, to the bishops, the administrative assistants, and the administrative assistant Huffman, God bless you, superintendents, pastors, and elders. I do honor our beloved general supervisor, Mother Barbara McCoo Lewis. Let's give her a hand. She was unable to be here on today, but Mother Huffman, I want you to know she's praying for you. I saw also give honor to Jurisdictional Supervisor Corrine Hoffman, who has served this district jurisdiction over 20 years. God bless you, and we love you. I am Supervisor Gladys Ross, representing the Women's Department, a member of the Executive Board. Mother asked me to come and represent the Department of Women on the transition of our dear beloved Bishop Lee Vicker's Broom. What a true servant of the Lord. To the bereaved family, our dear Mother Broom, God bless you And Mother Lewis loves you. She's praying for you. She wanted to come, but she just couldn't be here on today. She said that Bishop Broom was a dear friend of her husband's. They were jurisdictional secretaries in the various jurisdictions for many years, and then they were both bishops. And she wanted you to know that she loves you, she's praying for you, and God bless you. Bishop Broom was a godly man, a man who loved God and loved God's people. He was truly a churchman who served this church, his jurisdiction, well. May God bless him. He was loved by many, just a kind gentleman, friendly personality, outstanding. And he loved everybody, and he mostly loved his God. As a personal note, Bishop Boone was a friend to my husband, Elder Joshua Ross. He ran several revivals at this church, at his local church. And he and Bishop had such a remarkable relationship. Bishop fought a good fight. He kept the faith. And now he's in the arms of Jesus Christ, his Lord. Bishop Boone loved God. He loved the people of God. So Mother Boone, Mother Lewis wants you to know she sat in that same seat. She knows how you feel. But at times when you're going to miss him, seeing him calling your name, those are the times when you have to look to the hill, hallelujah, from which cometh your help. And realizing that your help doesn't come from who you know and how much money you have, but your help comes from the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. There were times, many times, when you stood by his and was there with him as he suffered and went through. But now the family, and you know where he is at home with the Lord. May God bless you, bless your family, bless your relatives, and all of the church family that will dearly miss him. And I encourage you to keep looking up, because God is always looking down. At this time, Mother Huffman will read the resolution from the Department of Women. May God bless you. The Women's Department is praying for you, and we love you with the love of the Lord. God bless you.
Thank you, Mother. Amen. International Department of Women, excuse me, Church of God in Christ, Inc. Mother Barbara McCool Lewis, General Supervisor. Mother William A. Rivers, General Supervisor Emeritus. Bishop J. Drew Shearer, Presiding Bishop and Chief Apostle. Resolution. Then the king said to his men, "Do you not realize that a commander and the great man has fallen in Israel this day?" 2 Samuel 3:38. Whereas we pay tribute to the life and legacy of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom, prelate of Oklahoma Northwest Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. And whereas our Heavenly Father has called from labor to reward one of the revered fathers of our church, we are confident in that it is rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. And whereas Bishop Broom was a devoted husband to his wife of 50 years, Martha Broom, from this union are two sons and two daughters, grandchildren and great-grandchildren. And whereas Bishop Broom has history with the Church of God in Christ, where at the age of 5, he met Bishop Charles Harrison Mason at a tent revival. In 1967, he was installed as the pastor of the First Church of God in Christ in Sepulpa, Oklahoma, and then Pastor Pawnee Church of God in Christ in Mount Zion, number 2, Church of God in Christ, Okmulgee, Oklahoma. Whereas Bishop Broom was as distinguished as a man of church community action, as he served as adjutant, assistant secretary, assistant superintendent, and superintendent in the Oklahoma Northwest jurisdiction, along with many international church positions, until 1995, when he was installed as prelate of the Oklahoma Northwest Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. And whereas Bishop had a love for the church and an untiring spirit of service. His dedication was without reservation. He was a friend to the multifaceted ministries of the International Department of Women and its Women's International Convention. His wisdom, understanding, and kindness to those with whom he came in contact left an indelible impression and shall always be a living memorial to him. And whereas it is befitting that we, the International Department of Women, pause and honor Bishop Broom, stalwart servant of the Lord, be it resolved that in his homegoing we have sustained a great loss, but his memory and his example will always serve as a measure of strength to us. May we hold fast the legacy of faith, trust, and good works inherited from this servant of the Lord as we express gratitude to God for having shared with us the life of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom. Be it further resolved that we extend to the bereaved biological church and ecclesiastical families and our sincere love, concern, and prayers, knowing that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. For God has promised, I will never leave you comfortless. I will come to you. John 14:18. Be it finally resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy placed in the archives of the International Department of Women, Church of God in Christ, Inc. Prayerfully submitted this 27th day of April in the year of our Lord, 2023. Mother Barbara McCool Lewis, General Supervisor. Mother Dr. Wilma J. Huey, First Assistant General Supervisor. Mother Vanessa Windwish Gatlin, Second Assistant General Supervisor. Mother Mary Jane Walton, Third Assistant General Supervisor. Thank you.
Amen. Praise God. Blessings. Thank you. The women received a special privilege today because I was too busy having a good time and didn't forgot to tell them. But we need you to, if you're going to read the resolution, please don't extend remarks. If you're going to give remarks, then we can forego the resolutions for the sake of time. Is that okay? For the others that are coming, amen. Clap your hands for the women's department again. Thank you, Mother Ross. Thank you so much. We will have tributes from the General Council of Pastors and Elders, and of course, our chairman is not here, Chairman Edie, but his vice chairman is here, and he's, I believe, or is Dr. Sims going to do that? I see Reverend William Sims is going to do, but our vice chairman is here. We will have tribute from the College of Bishops in behalf of Bishop Albert Galbert Jr. And the representative will be, of course, the Right Reverend Mark L. Gilkey from Wichita, Kansas. There's no representative here for the judiciary, but I'm sure a resolution will be coming. And also, we have resolution from the General Assembly in behalf of Bishop Thuston. The Reverend Elder Simpson is going to do that in his behalf. And there is no representative for the General Secretary, but I'm sure he's going to have a resolution presented to the family. Will you come in that order? Thank you so much.
Certainly respect Presiding Bishop on today in the Presidium, to all the distinguished guests and people of the Lord, I would like to ask Vice Chairman Kimba Nolan to come stand with me, then also the Chairman of the Northwest Jurisdiction, Elder Finkley, as well, if he's here. And so now I simply present the Vice Chairman of the General Council of Pastors and Elders.
Amen. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Are you excited about being in God's house? I know it's a sad situation, but if you take a moment and say, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, even with tears in my eyes, my soul will still cry out hallelujah, and I'll thank God. Can anybody still thank God? Can you only thank God when the sun is shining? But when clouds come your way, do you still have enough praise on the inside of you to give him glory? Honor to our presiding bishop, Bishop J. Drew Sheard, and to the members of the general board that are here. God bless you, all of you, my brothers and sisters in the Lord. To the wonderful women in the Lord, God bless each and every one of you all. Thank you, Elder Sims, and thank you, Elder Finkley, for standing with me. I'd ask all of the pastors and elders that are present, if you all would stand with me on behalf of our chairman, Michael Eady, to show this family that we are here to support you, Mother Broom in Oklahoma, Northwest, in this time. I want to share with you that, of course, my name is Kaimba Nolan, and I came into the Church of God in Christ through Lawton, Oklahoma. Yeah. I got licensed to preach there under Superintendent Jimmy Stevenson, under the leadership of Bishop J.A. Young. I was sent up for ordination under the leadership of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom, and they told me to come back next year. I'm not going to tell y'all who I remember, but Bishop Broom, he saw something in me and gave me an opportunity to serve, my first opportunity to serve the Episcopacy of the Church of God in Christ. Bishop Broom, Mother Broom would always talk of a time when I assisted her and Bishop with their grandsons. And I think I recognize one of those faces in here this morning, Mother. They always made me feel special. When I deployed to Korea after being commissioned, this jurisdiction sent me care packages, newsletters, to keep me connected. And I will never forget that. This jurisdiction goes with me everywhere I go. You all are part of my story. And when Bishop Broom did ordain me finally, thank you, brothers. Bishop Broom did ordain me, and the gentleman that preached the ordination service was the chairman of the General Council of Pastors and Elders at that time, Bishop Newton. And Emmanuel Newton was the chairman at that time. And these things have been a rich part of my upbringing in the church. So Mother Broom, thank you to this jurisdiction, to the men that helped support Bishop Broom as he was our leader. Thank you for undergirding him and being a very present help to him. And we came just to honor him and to say thank God for the life, the legacy, the leadership, and the impact of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom. Now, when God gives you something, you ought to tell him thank you. I say, when God gives you something, you ought to tell him thank you. Can we praise God for what was given to us in this jurisdiction? Mother, we love you. Family, we love you. Jurisdiction, we love you. And we'll be praying for you. This resolution we do have, we'll present it to you by Elder Finkley, your chairman. Amen. And Chairman Eady does sends his love and regards. God bless you.
Can we put our hands together and give God praise for his goodness, his greatness, his awesomeness? Come on, bless the Lord, everybody. God bless you to the presidium of our great church and to our presiding bishop and chief apostle, the Most Reverend J. Drew Sheard. College of Bishops, I'm going to ask that Bishop Liddell Thomas will come stand with me as we present our resolution on today to this great family. We love Bishop Broom. Great history. My dad, Bishop J.C. Gilkey, and Bishop Broom were in the College of Bishops together. We have such a great history, Kansas and Oklahoma. We love you, family, and we're praying for you. Can we praise God for this wonderful family? Board of Bishops resolution. We, the members of the Board of Bishops of the Church of God in Christ, Inc., in a gesture of solidarity, stand with the elected officers and executive board to resolve the following to the family of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom. Whereas God in his great power has removed from our midst a Christian brother who was faithful and a help to his fellow men. Those who were encouraged and cheered by his words of wisdom will long feel his influence, loyalty, friendship, and service shall be his legacy. Whereas, as the demise of Bishop Lee Vicker Broom, who served with the distinction as the prelate of the Oklahoma Northwest Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction, and who also served faithfully and dutifully as a dedicated and long-standing pastor in the Church of God in Christ, the body of Christ and the world at large has suffered a great loss. Bishop Broom's service expressed and the gravitas of him being a prince in the Lord's church, having the distinct honor of serving our church as a defender of the Church of God in Christ, faith and foundation of holiness. Be it resolved that we express the sympathy that we feel personally and collectively to his families. Biologically and church, we admonish you to rely on the comfort of our gracious God of heaven and earth. Be it resolved that our church and this world has been a better place because this churchman and father of the gospel, the Bishop Lee Vicker Broom, blessed us with his presence and his godly example of service. Numerous areas of service and leadership he has rendered to our great church, serving with honor and distinction. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution is given to the family, and a copy be kept in the official archives of the Board of Bishops of the Church of God in Christ, World Headquarters, Memphis, Tennessee. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit, Psalms 34 and 18. Given under my hand and the seal of the Board of Bishops, this 27th day of April 2023, Bishop Albert Galbraith, Chairman of the Board of Bishops, and our Secretary, the Bishop Adrian D. Williams. God bless you, family. We love you, and we are praying for you.
Job, presiding bishop, and to the general board members. I'm here to represent the chairman of the board, General Assembly, Bishop Thurston. He called and asked me to make it. He couldn't come and give his sympathies to the Broom family. So I drove from Kansas down to tell you all that he's praying for you. And he's, the thoughts is that he couldn't get a plane out. And I thought about it. I said, our life is measured with time. And it starts out like sand in an hourglass, and so are the days of our time, days, our lives. And it goes all the way through to the end, and then one day, the last grain of salt, sand will flow through the hourglass. God bless you.
Let's praise God for these tributes from all of our national offices and Mother Broom, and certainly to the siblings of Bishop Broom, the Church of God and family. The Church of God in Christ loves you. And he served the national church as well as its jurisdiction and the local church. My father was certainly endeared by Bishop Broom, and I remember many occasions coming here and certainly being in fellowship, and even to some of the other ecumenical fellowships that you all have in this region. And we thank God for the legacy that's right here in Oklahoma. Amen. All right, so we do have a representative. Amos Allen.
Elder Amos Allen for the General Secretary. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Come right on, sir.
Greetings. Today it becomes my privilege to present the General Church tribute on behalf of Bishop Joel Harley Lyles, Jr., General Secretary, who regrettably is unable to be present today in response to cautionary restraints. He was asked to be observed by his medical team. Please allow me to convey his sincere condolences. In deference to time, allow me to recite the initial and the final stanzas of the General Church Resolution. A formal copy will be presented to the family to share during their moments of quiet reflections. Whereas Bishop Lee Vicker Broom was a gentle soul, lover of the people and friends to mankind, a preacher of righteousness and a father to generations, his undeniable love for the church made him a servant of the people and the saints of God. Many great men have been called to preach, but Bishop Lee Vicker Broom was called to change a generation. Be it further resolved that the obsequies observed today, replete with flourishes and banners in tribute to the life of the late Bishop Lee Vicker Broom, beloved husband of 50 years, to Evangelist Martha Broom, a faithful father and a faithful grandfather and a patriot, a shepherd par excellence to the Lord's heritage. He was the prelate of the Oklahoma Northwest jurisdictions, and he shall be chronicled and canonized in the archives of the Church of God in Christ. That in ceremonial tribute to this fallen soldier, the flag of the Church of God in Christ, located at Mason Temple World Headquarters, shall be lowered and flown at half mast as we observe a proper period of mourning. Given under the great seal of the church this 27th day of April in the year of our Lord 2023, Bishop Joel Harley Lyles, Jr., General Secretary, Church of God in Christ.
Bless you. Amen. Say amen. Well, we want to certainly thank each of you for coming, and good to see my dear friend and brother, one of the sons of the Church of God in Christ, Bishop Carlton Pearson. Amen. Bless you, sir. I'm getting older, he's getting younger. I don't understand what that is. Amen. Thank you, Sarah, for bringing him. I know you did. He said he brought her. He loved Bishop Broom too as well. We thank God for each of you. Now it's time for the amazing word of God. The Church of God in Christ has been blessed with incredible leadership, and I've had the pleasure of meeting most of our leaders. I was 3 years old when Bishop Mason passed, and I don't have the testimonies other than he laid hands on him and all that. I remember vaguely when I was in Pentecost Temple, he was coming up the steps while I was sitting near the drum. They just said, get out the way. But I have had the pleasure of meeting and greeting and fellowshipping with all of our elected presiding bishops. And I must say that my friend and brother and leader, the Bishop J. Drew Sheard, has become one of the most incredible leaders we've had. Amen. In a short window of time, and of course, we're not instructed to say these things, but it is what it is. He has brought impeccable leadership to the Church of God in Christ, and many people were just looking at the church to see what Kojic is doing next. Now they're looking up to see what Kojic is doing next. Amen. Just announced in our General Assembly meeting that the Church of God in Christ is debt-free. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. And of course, I know it is a collage of participation, but leadership gets you there. And our leader is one that gets us there. And through his leadership during the pandemic, he's had, I'm sure, other than Bishop Mason, one of the most difficult times to lead.
and he's allowed God to use him in an incredible way. I believe unequivocally that he's anointed to do this. You know, a lot of people can be chosen to lead, but God has chosen him for such a time as this. He's anointed to do this. And I thank God for his leadership and for the reputation, the credibility that he's given to this office as he has traveled the length and breadth, not only of this country, but yea, the world. He's been in many nations so far representing Kojic, as well as standing on political platforms to echo this, that, and the other. We just recently had one of our Kojic sons to be elected mayor in Chicago. Amen. And Bishop J. Drew Shear was a pivotal part of that celebration and becoming. And not only that, but some of the other casualties of black lives that have taken place in our community. He's been a voice and allowed our social justice ministry of the Church of God in Christ to be in a key place to resound the truth that we represent. I'm thankful, and thank you, Presiding Bishop, for giving me the opportunity to stand and introduce you and, of course, to share in this program for Bishop Broom. I'm going to ask, after the choir would have finished their selection, that all would stand other than the family, and let's receive our presiding bishop, eighth in succession, the one and only Bishop J. Drew Shear. Will you thank God for them in that order? Amen.
Check. When you're lonely and filled with despair, just remember her. And when you're in doubt, you can't find your way out, just remember my God will see you. Yes, he will. Just call on the name. Just call his name. Oh, no. Oh. Oh, precious is his name. Oh, when you're lonely and filled with despair, when you're in doubt, you can't find your way out, just remember my God will see. Yes, he will. Just call on the name. Just call his name aloud. Oh, oh, oh. Oh, how precious Jesus. Oh, how precious, yeah. Yes, precious is the mighty name of Jesus. Yeah. Oh, oh, how precious. Hallelujah. It's the name. He will be there every time you call. Oh, how precious is a neighbor. Yeah, oh, he will be there every time you fall. His name is Jesus. 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 Jesus, 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 help me call his name up. Help me call his name up. Jesus, 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 Alpha and Omega. Beginning and the end, hey, Jesus, 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 my way maker, Jesus, my strong tower, Jesus, my deliverer, Jesus, my healer, Jesus, there's nobody like him, Jesus, nobody like him, Jesus, nobody like him, Jesus, 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 a mother, a father, a sister, hey, a brother, my doctor, my lawyer, Jesus, 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 Jesus. When I call him, he's right there. When I call him, he's right there. He'll turn it around, turn it around, turn it around, turn it around. The more I call him, the better I feel. The more I call him, the better I feel. Jesus, 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 Jesus. They died. He died on the cross. Pierced them in the side just for you and me. He laid there. One day, he laid there. 2 days, but on that third day, he got up. He got up. He got up with the power. Oh, power. Oh, power. Oh, power. Call him. Call him. Call him. Call him. Jesus. Jesus. Yeah. Oh. Precious. Yes. He's so precious. Precious, precious is his name, is his name.
Oh, come on, let's give God some praise. Let's give God some praise. I leaned over and told Bishop Porter and Bishop Bryan, it's hard to sit down on Jesus. When you get to calling Jesus, somebody ought to move. Look at your neighbor and say, call on Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Woo! Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer. And the people of the Lord said, amen. Thank you so much. Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want to say that I'm saved and sanctified. And I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. And that with the mighty burning fire. And I do speak in tongues as the Spirit give utterance. We praise God for this wonderful family. Mother Broom, we're praying for you. We love you. We praise God for the children, for the entire family. We praise God for the Oklahoma Northwest family. For the local church family. We're praying for you. And we're praying for ourselves, because we've lost a dear friend, a dear brother, a hard worker. He was my friend. I'm glad he was my friend. And I thank God for him. Thank you, Brother Secretary of the General Board, Bishop Brandon Porter. Thank you for being here. I know he and Bishop Bryant had some challenges getting here. Of course, all of us seem to have had some challenges getting here. They sent my vestments to El Paso, Texas. And I guess they should be here now, but it's too late now. And so we thank God for these bishops, Bishop Brian and Bishop Colby, who is here in Oklahoma. Bishop Hankerson and the Board of Bishops and our visiting bishops, my dear brother, Bishop Carlton, and God bless Mother Gladys Ross, who is standing in for our wonderful supervisor. God bless you, Mother Huffman. We're praying for you. And to all of the supervisors, God bless our dear sister, our big sister, Sister Sarah Jordan Powell. God bless the Superintendent Kaimba Nolan. And the pastors and elders council, all of the missionaries, all of the saints and friends. I'm going to be very brief, and I'm going to meet with the pastors right after this service to just give you some direction and just be at ease. You're in good hands, and you're going to be taken care of in a very special way because Bishop Broom was dear to us. Allow me to read a scripture, and if I don't do it justice, Bishop Liddell Thomas is sitting here and he can take it and do better. But it's found in the book of Psalms, the 17th number of Psalm and the 15th verse. If you'll be so kind to stand in reverence to the word of God. Psalm 17 and 15. As for me, I will behold thy face in righteousness. I shall be satisfied when I awake with thy likeness. I shall be satisfied. That's what I'm going to talk to you for the next few minutes from the subject. I shall be satisfied. Say that with me. I shall be satisfied. Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. On a daily basis, we are pushed to make choices. We must choose whether or not we will get out of bed. We must choose what will we do with the day ahead. We must choose after a day of decisions, what will we do for the evening. Due to the choices we make, either good or bad, every man, woman, boy, and girl must deal with the outcome as they pursue life.
Sometimes we're happy and sometimes we're sad. In our text, the psalmist discusses the choices he made based on his observance. In this psalm, he solicits the attention of the Lord and prays for justice. He identifies himself as making the choice to be free from deceit and desirous of the reward that comes as a result of his choice. David shares that God had searched his heart, tested his intents, and found that he was determined to be free from anything that might be classified as sin. He asserted that his steps had remained firmly in the path of righteousness. My brothers and sisters, each of us, as we make decisions on a daily basis, should endeavor to have such a testimony. In the midst of difficulties and setbacks, we must maintain our godly integrity. David, in essence, said that when it was all said and done, he would see the Lord's face in peace. However, it was this same David who noted how he attended public worship where the Ark of the Covenant was. David spoke of the joy of being in the house of the Lord. He enjoyed going to church. Oh, help me, Holy Ghost. Because I believe that every saint ought to be glad to go to church. David said he would be satisfied when he awoke with thy likeness. My brothers and sisters, this awakening that he spoke of was the awakening out of the sleep of death. In other words, David anticipated living a godly life, dying, and then rising in peace. Therefore, this indicates a time of satisfaction to the believer after a life of making the right choices. My brothers and sisters, in the 11th chapter of Hebrews, starting at the 24th verse, Moses apparently was faced with making a life decision, and the Bible says, choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season. Moses esteemed the reproaches of Christ greater riches than the treasures in Egypt. How do you know that, brother preacher? For the Bible says, by faith he forsook Egypt, not fearing the wrath of the king, for he endured as seeing him who is invisible. I wonder, church, can you get a glimpse of him who is invisible? I need to tell you that our choices reveal our character. In fact, there is no better sign of character than the manner in which men make decisions. Let us know that I'm going to my seat here. The landscape that preceded the choice of Moses, the world placed before him its very best, and religion placed before him its very worst. And between the best of the world and the worst of religion, Moses made a choice. The world placed before him honor, that of being the son of Pharaoh's daughter, pleasure, the pleasures of sin, sensual and sensational and unhealthy mental excitement, and three, wealth, the treasures of Egypt. Religion set before him afflictions and the reproaches of Christ. Bishop Broom had to make such a choice. And in a very real sense, we have to make such a choice. What was it that influenced Moses in making his choice? What was it that caused Broom to not throw in the towel amidst his sickness? I want to tell you what it was. It was faith. Faith. takes us from the front porch of hell to the stairways of heaven. Faith moves mountains. Faith will open the fountain. And if you have faith, you can please God. I wish I had a witness here. Say what you will, but we all want something that will satisfy us to the depths of our being. And the world displays its many options for us to consider. For some, it's money. Yeah, give me money. That's what I want. And if I have money, I will be happy. I could buy what I want, go where I want, and be who I want. Others want power to be able to determine the temporary destiny of others, to be able to call the shots and determine who's up and who's down. Bishop had a choice, and he chose to live a life so he could be satisfied in the end. He made a decision to let go of the world and cling to the unfailing hand of our God. He wanted to see God at work in his life. He desired to be submissive to his ultimate plan. All he really wanted was to live so that when he had come to the end of his journey, he would see God's face in peace. My brothers and sisters, that's all any of us should want. We should want to hear the Lord say, well done. No wonder the songwriter picked it up and said, I'll take Jesus for mine. You may have this whole round world, but I'll take Jesus for mine. I surmise that this songwriter became aware that if he didn't have Jesus, he really didn't have anything. And then another songwriter who apparently had been submerged into the difficulties of life picked it up and said, I'm happy with Jesus alone. Though poor and deserted, thank God I can say, I'm happy with Jesus alone. So a decision was made. I wonder today, have you made a decision? Some folk would rather have silver and gold. Some folk would rather have riches untold. But these things are measureless when they are compared to your soul. Do me a favor, if you made a decision, look at somebody and tell them, but I've decided to make Jesus my choice. Church, I'd rather have Jesus. I'd rather have Jesus than houses and land. I'd rather be led by his nail-pierced hand. I'd rather have Jesus than men's applause. I'd rather be faithful to the Lord's call. I'd rather have Jesus than worldwide fame. I'd rather be true to his holy and righteous name. Do me a favor and tell your neighbor, I'd rather have Jesus. And so Bishop counted up the cost. For I heard in the 8th chapter of Mark, in the 36th and 37th verses, it said, for what shall it profit a man if he gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall a man give in exchange for his soul? I'd rather have Jesus. It gives credence as to why Bishop Broom didn't give up. He coincided with the Apostle Paul when he said in the 20th chapter of Acts and the 22nd through the 24th verses, and now behold, I go bound in the spirit unto Jerusalem, not knowing the things that shall befall me there, save that the Holy Ghost witnesseth in every city, saying that bonds and afflictions abide me, but none of these things move me. I wish I had somebody to help me say, but none of these things move me. Neither count I my life dear unto myself, so that I might finish my course with joy and the ministry which I have received of the Lord Jesus to testify the gospel of the grace of God. Well, if when you give the best of your service, telling the world that the Savior has come, be not dismayed when men don't believe you. He'll understand and say, well done. Good night, Bishop. We won't say goodbye because he's gone to another place where the wicked shall cease from troubling and the weary shall be at rest, and all of the saints of the ages shall sit at his feet and be blessed. My brothers and sisters, I know he'll be satisfied, because we know that if this earthly house of this tabernacle be dissolved, thank God I got another building, a building not made by man, but eternal in the heavens. No more crying over there, because Jesus said, I'm going to wipe all tears from your eyes. No more sickness over there, because they tell me there's a tree where the leaves are good for the healing of the nation. And that's why liars can't stop me, hypocrites won't block me, slander can't hinder me, and backbiters won't deter me, because I got heaven in my view. For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory that shall be revealed in us. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, hang in there, because as soon as my feet strike Zion, I won't have to war no more. Serving the Lord will pay off after a while. If you live right, heaven belongs to you. 2 Chronicles 15:7 said, be ye strong therefore, and let not your hands be weak, for your work shall be rewarded. Galatians 6:9 said, and let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season ye shall reap if you faint not. 1 Corinthians 15:58 said, therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. I gotta leave this alone, but do me one more favor. Grab somebody by the hand and pull on them and push them. Y'all ain't pulling on nobody. Y'all ain't pushing nobody. But pull on them and push them. And say, neighbor, when it's all over, be satisfied. When I see my Savior, be satisfied. No more weeping. No more crying. No more lying. So wild. It'll all be over after a while. The sun is gonna shine. I came by to tell somebody, don't wait till this battle is over. You can shout right now. You can shout right now. Say, don't wait.
I gotta stop.
Don't give up. Don't give in. Payday is coming after a while. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They your mount up. Just look at somebody and say, after a while, I'll be satisfied. Look at somebody, you got the wrong neighbor. Look at somebody else and say, neighbor, after a while, put a little music in your voice this time and say, ah, be satisfied. God bless you. Oh, my, 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 hallelujah. I got to stop that musician. It's just a rehearsal. It's just a rehearsal. Look at somebody and say, it's just a rehearsal. I gotta stop, my time is up. But if I had about 10 more minutes, I'd show y'all how to have church. Look at somebody and say, it's just a rehearsal. Because after a while, it'll all be over. Alright. Ain't he alright? Ain't he alright? Ain't he alright? Look at your neighbor and say, no, he's alright. Oh, my, 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 my. Everyone except the family is standing. For as much as it is pleased Almighty God to take out of this world our deceased, the Right Reverend Lee Vicker Broom, we commit his body to Mother Earth. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. Looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life and world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ. At whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like him to his own glorious body, according to the working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Let us recite the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. From henceforth, Yea, saith the Spirit, that they rest from their labors and their works do follow them. We're coming to the close of this service, and we have done the committal here, and I believe that this is a family time, very private, when people shall go to lay the remains of their loved ones to rest. And so that's why we do the committal in this service and allow the family to have that private time with our beloved brother. I'm going to meet the pastors of the Northwest Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. Where am I meeting them?
We'll meet over in the fellowship hall. There's a meeting place there. We'll lead you out.
Don't worry, it'll only be a 10-minute meeting. I know that many of you all are going to other places back home, and of course the family is going to the final resting place. The elder Glenn McKinney will actually be doing the interment there. Now may the God of peace, brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, the great shepherd of the sheep, by the blood of the eternal Jesus, equip you to do his will, working in you that which is pleasing in his sight. Through Jesus Christ, to whom be the glory forever and ever. And may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Some glad morning, when this life is over,
as we prepare to detabernacle the bier, I'm going to ask that the jurisdictional secretary, Elder Amos Allen, will lead the elders over to the meeting room where the presiding bishop will join you momentarily. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon thee and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace.
I'll fly away. I'll fly away. Fly away. I'll fly away. I'll fly away to that city. I'll fly away. I'll fly away. Yes, I'll fly away. Can't wait to see him. Can't wait to see him. I'll fly away. I'm living right, walking right and talking right. I'll fly away. Yes, I'm gonna fly away. Yes, I'm gonna fly away.